Breakdowns and the increasing operational costs have highlighted the importance of using health sensors in water pumping stations. To meet the operator's needs, Grundfos offers IO113, a pump protection module. Grundfos IO113 works protecting the pumps individually and can be part of communication network. So, we will be able to read all the data and act if the system requires it. The feature allows us to integrate the units in the customer SCADA system. Different systems and configurations are set in the dip switch included in the IO113. Now, we will show you how to set a two-pump system. Initially, we check if IO113 is working individually. Simulating different failures, such as thermal switch and moisture switch, we will see how IO113 acts. We will check the pump too, thermal switch and moisture switch to evaluate if it is working. After it, we will check if water in oil sensor works. Once we have tested and confirmed that the units are working individually, we will continue with the bus addresses settings. Verify that you wired and connected the communication plugs. Then change the dip's position depending on protocol and the position of pumps in the network. We will set the dips 3, 4, and 5. If more than one pair of IO113 and SM113 are used in the control system, make sure that address settings are handled pair by pair. In our example, dip 9 remains because we are connecting via Genibus. Through the PC tool view on your right, we confirm the data transference from the two units of IO113 in the network. Again, and to verify that we will receive the correct pump information in our control platform. We simulate the thermal switches, the moisture switches, and verify that status is updated. Finally, after simulation, we can confirm that IO113 information is transmitted through communications line to the main control. Grundfos IO113 can work alone or together with the Grundfos controller CU362. The combination of two devices brings to the user the high pump protection features in IO113 plus all the benefits from the smart controller. As a result, it will reduce the breakdowns and it will reduce the operational tasks in the water stations. In the following video, we will show you the easy settings in the CU362 to integrate the IO113. Remember that the system is modular and open, so you can extend the system when you consider. Once the Genibus wires are connected, switch on the controller. To set the IO113, we ran the wizard commissioning assistant. You will find it in settings, general settings. First, wizard will ask you to set your language. After it, you have to set the date. During the process, you will set the units, number of pumps and type of level control sensor. In our example, two pumps with pressure sensor. Here you can also set the pit depth. After this step, the assistant will ask you the different modules installed. Here we will set the 2I0113. If we have more modules in our panel, we must set those here. In the next screen, we should define the type of configuration regarding level switches in pit. In our example, we set the configuration 1. After it, we will set the electrical type of level control sensor. We select 0-10 volts and set the sensor range. Then is possible set the start and stop levels to pumps, either the overflow and the dry running level. Through wizard, it is possible to set some pump and system options. It can be used to adapt the panel and functions to the real system. In the example, we skip the point. The wizard also offers digital input settings. After it, pump controller was configured so we can set pumps in operation. Once in the status menu, with enough level to activate the pumps, we are going to simulate alarms in IO113 to see the control behavior. In the menu alarms, we check that we are receiving the alarms from the two IO113 and pumps. First, we tested the PTC and moisture switch in pump 1. The system will alarm you. Meanwhile, the IO113 transmitted that status. After pump 1, we are doing the same with the pump 2. Going back to the menu status, selecting in each pump, we can access to all data from IO113. In the example, we are simulating water in oil sensor changes. It will triggers warning based on the values. We have arrived at the end of this video. Please remember, take all preventive measures to avoid accidents during the works. Previous the dip switches configuration and wirings, check the type of protection and the sensors in your pump. The SM113 installation should be inside the pump. Use screened cable to reduce the noise from others' electronic devices. IO113 should be installed in a low voltage area. To improve the operations and cost reduction, IO113 installations can be expanded with the Grundfos dedicated control. The purpose of this video is to show a basic generalist example. Always read the manual beforehand and contact your manager if you have questions. Thank you for your attention.